The other night, I got a hold of a clip that was a phone interview done by a woman to Mellssa Huckaby. And, you know, the murderer, the alleged murder of Sandra Cantu. In that interview, the Mellssa was much more relaxed. And I was halfway through the interview when it dawned on me that she and Casey Anthony were a match. In style and in the some maneuvering, there was just really some similarities there. And complete with the absurdity of she couldn't report the suitcase stolen because it was under 200 and she doesn't have the internet. You know, you get the drift. I've got a link for you, but it's with another interviewer, and it's the phone is not as, the reception is not as good. So I hope if anybody recognizes this, they will please notify me or put it down, and so we can all listen to it. But it was a, I think, a local station, and it was a woman. But now, getting back to this. This is so incredibly rare to have two antisocial personalities working to, at the same time. I mean, their story's breaking. Clearly to me, Mellssa is wanting to do a better job of covering up than Casey. And so that she deliberately tries to present herself as a person of a split personality during the interview with the police. But when she's making on these phone interviews, she's still very innocent. There's no confessions going on or anything like that. Mellssa, if I'm correct, she is another antisocial personality who takes the route of enjoying torture. She's the type that when she was a child would put the kitten in the dryer or put, you know, like somebody we all know, put a firecracker up the anus of a frog. They enjoy inducing pain and the power of control over their victim. I believe that it is very possible that the two young children, her own daughter plus the neighbor's daughter, Sandra Cantu, had played some sort of nasty game with this mother, something like doctor, and it hurt, and she made the children do it. But this time little Sandra may have said no, and I'm going to tell my mommy, which necessitated killing her. And she would do, I'm sure she would do these things, these hideous things in front of her own child, because this is a way to ensure the silence of any witness. The child is terrified, and you see a real Stockholm syndrome coming in here. Anyway, this is a lot of speculation. But this is the way I think it just might have played out. We have a woman, and the sex part is not all that important. I mean, it could have been a little boy, what was important was the size and the ease of controlling. These horrible people never pick on people their own size. Have you noticed that? Well, that's what it is. And I do not see her with any sort of personality or any psychotic things. I think this is just another antisocial personality that thrives on causing pain and torture. So, on that, we'll see how this thing pans out.